hedge fund strategies. So we can divide hedge fund strategies into four different categories. Number one is event driven strategies. Number two, relative value strategies. Number three, macro strategies. And number four, equity hedge fund strategies. Now each of these categories have subcategories except third one. So macro strategies do not have any subcategories under that. Rest three strategies have subcategories under that. So first let's start with event driven strategies. Here hedge fund manager try to make profits from short term events expected to affect individual companies. Focus on the word events. Now here the event can be mergers and acquisition. Let's say for example we have two companies, company A and company B. Now this company A is very large company and it is planning to acquire company B. So here company A will be termed as acquirer, whereas company B will be termed as target company. So when this news comes out of this, you know, potential acquisition, generally it is seen that stock price of target company goes up and stock price of acquirer comes down. So here what, you know, fund manager can do, fund manager can go long on the shares of target company and simultaneously fund manager can go short on the shares of acquirer company. So this type of strategy is called as a merger arbitrage strategy. So this is the very first subcategory under event driven strategies. So under merger arbitrage, fund manager can go long on the shares of target company and simultaneously fund manager can go short on the shares of acquirer. Next subcategory is distressed slash restructuring. Here fund manager invest in distressed companies with the expectation of successful turnaround after restructuring the firms. See what happens when a security is distressed. Generally stock price of distressed company trade at a deep discount valuation, and if hedge fund manager believes that restructuring the firm will improve the prospects of distressed companies, therefore fund manager take long position in those companies. Number three is active shareholder strategy. Under this strategy, hedge fund manager buy sufficient equity shares to influence a company's policy with the goal of increasing company value. So continuing with the example of distressed company, a fund manager buy the sufficient equity shares of distressed company in order to influence the company's policies with the goal of making situation of a company more better in the future. Next category is relative value strategies. Here the hedge fund manager try to make profits from pricing discrepancy between related securities. Now here you need to focus on the word related securities, hence the name is relative value strategy. And very first subcategory is fixed income convertible arbitrage. So under this, you know, this strategy typically involved going long on the convertible bond issued by the company and simultaneously going short on the equity shares issued by the firm. Let's understand with the help of example. Fund manager basically takes long position in convertible bond and simultaneously he takes short position in the equity shares. Now let's see what happen when price of equity shares increases. So when price of equity shares increases, first of all, fund manager will face loss on short position. And as price of equity shares increases, he can, you know, convert this bond into equity shares. So he can set off the losses made in short position by converting the bond into equity shares at lower value. Now let's see what happens when price of equity shares decreases. First of all, fund manager will make profits on short position in equity shares, and now as price is falling, so there is no need of conversion. He can retain this bond and earn interest from it. Important note for you, this strategy is known as zero beta strategy. Now zero beta strategy in the sense, this strategy don't have to do anything with the market. Generally this strategy tends to perform well regardless of market movement. That's why it is known as a zero beta strategy. We have other subcategories as well, B, C and D. At this stage, you simply remember the name. There is very less probability that you will be tested in detail on these subcategories. So simply remembering the names will do for you. So second one is asset backed security. Here fund manager, you know, take positions in asset backed securities. Next is general fixed income. Here fund manager takes positions in normal fixed income securities. And last is volatility. So here fund manager takes, you know, positions based on volatility in market. Number three, we have macro strategies. These strategies are based on global economic trends and events, and it may involve long or short positions in equities, fixed income, currencies or commodities. So here fund manager do the global analysis of economic trends. So if fund manager believes that globally equity markets tend to do well in near future, he can take, you know, long positions in equities. If his analysis says that global equity markets will not perform good, fund manager can take short positions in equity markets. Number four, we have equity hedge fund strategies. Here the hedge fund manager seek to profit from long or short position in publicly traded equities and derivatives with equities as their underlying asset. So very first subcategory we have market neutral. Now here fund manager can use either technical analysis or fundamental analysis to identify undervalued or overvalued securities. Once fund manager identify undervalued and overvalued security, he can take long position in undervalued securities and short positions in overvalued securities in approximately equal amount. Important note for you, again this is the zero beta strategy and tends to do well regardless of the market movements. Next subcategory is fundamental growth. Here again fund manager use fundamental analysis to identify growth companies. Once he gets the list of growth companies, he started to take long positions in the same. Next is fundamental value. Here again fund manager use fundamental analysis to identify undervalued securities. Next is quantitative directional. Now here fund manager basically use technical analysis to identify undervalued and overvalued securities. So you have to remember the difference in the fundamental value and quantitative directional. So So under fundamental value, fund manager use fundamental analysis to identify undervalued and overvalued securities, whereas in quantitative directional, fund manager basically use technical analysis to identify undervalued and overvalued securities. So fund manager can take long position in undervalued security and simultaneously he can take short position in overvalued securities. Last one is short bias. Here the hedge fund manager takes short position in overvalued equities and smaller long position but with negative market exposure. So here this basically means short positions tends to be greater than long position. As you can see here the word smaller long position. That's it in this video.